Tourism Malaysia experienced unprecedented partnerships at the Gulf Travel Show.
Gulf Travel Show is considered a gift during this pandemic, actually, because the first year we attended the Gulf Travel Show, it was something new for us, but we just figured out it's a sufficient virtual platform that connected our stakeholders with the trade partners. In the second year, we just got the diamond partnership with GTS, and we managed to bring a very successful meetings for our stakeholders. The visitor coming to Malaysia Pavilion, they're already aware of the brand of Malaysia Truly Asia. So the main reason they come is that they are missing Malaysia and they want to know when Malaysia is going to open and they want to know the updates happening in Malaysia. So the main purpose for them is to understand more about the new products that they can offer for their client and market. And in the meantime, to share with us their plans, because they are mainly planning for tours for relaxation, to visit the nature.
Swiss Travel System Excellence Program offers a unique e-learning platform for Swiss public transport.
It's giving a great overview of Switzerland as a travel destination, but the main focus is on the Swiss Travel System, that's the public transport system of Switzerland, which is quite unique. The program really helps to get an overview of the Swiss Travel System products, but also how to get around in Switzerland by public transport. So you don't have to be a Switzerland specialist to be able to participate in that program. It's also absolutely suitable for a beginner who is interested in Switzerland as a future destination in the portfolio.
Etihad begins the IATA Travel Pass trial on flights from Abu Dhabi to Chicago until May 31st. Leading global travel marketplace, Skyscanner has rolled out the Arabic language offerings across all domains. Flydubai relaunches flights to Batumi on their summer schedule.